Good day from Chem Help ASAP. Let's talk about how radical reactions end through the termination stage. At the top of the screen is our overall mock reaction. The overall reaction occurs through the reactions in the propagation stage. All good things must end, however, and radical reactions definitely end. The end is through the termination stage. Remember that radicals are destroyed in the termination stage. Okay, how exactly do you destroy a radical? Radicals are destroyed by having one radical combine with another radical to form a new molecule, which is not a radical. So radicals need to react with other radicals. In the past two videos, one on initiation and another on propagation, we have mentioned three potential radicals in our mock reaction. A dot formed in the initiation stage and cycled through the propagation steps. B dot formed in the initiation stage. And D dot appeared in the propagation steps. If any one of these radicals reacts with another one of these radicals, then that's a termination step. We have six possibilities, and I'll just show the products. A can react with A. A can react with B. A can react with D. B can react with B. B can react with D. Finally, D can react with D. All these are possible termination reaction products. All result in a decrease in radical concentration. In fact, all these reactions are very favorable energetically. Anytime you can go from two reactive intermediates to a stable molecule, then that's a favorable reaction. That brings up a question. Why don't termination reactions occur very quickly and essentially stop radical reactions dead? The answer to this question can be found by thinking about the concentration of radicals. Radical concentrations are extremely low, so the probability of two radicals colliding in the reaction is super low. Let's look at the rate equation for the reaction of A dot plus B dot going to AB. The rate will be equal to K, it's our rate constant, times the concentration of A dot times the concentration of B dot. This is a second order reaction. Since the concentrations of A dot and B dot are very small, the rate of the reaction is also very small. One final comment. If you look at one of our products from the termination reaction, formation of BD in the bottom left of the screen, it's the same as one of our main reaction products. Is it possible that BD forms primarily through the termination step, not the propagation steps? The answer is no, because the rate of termination steps is so slow, the amount of product that is formed from one of the termination steps is also vanishingly small. Essentially, all the D in the reaction will arise through the propagation steps. That covers the termination stage. Termination involves the combination of two radicals into a stable molecule. Termination steps are slow because the concentration of radicals is very low.